If you engage in behaviors, activities, thoughts, and emotions that you know are not serving you, then there is only one reason why, and that reason is because your brain has become hacked. And in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you the three sources that hack our brain so that you can have an awareness of them and eventually begin to let go of these sources and begin to show up with the activities, with the behaviors, with the habits that will serve you rather than hurt you. Okay, it's so important to understand that first and foremost, the source that hijacks our biology, which ends up affecting our psychology more than anything else, is the big food industry. Okay, understand that a lot of the food that is available, the majority of the food that is available in the supermarkets, actually hijacks our biochemistry. And this is something that they leverage in terms of our basic evolutionary program to survive and reproduce. And when we actually binge on these edible food-like substances, and I call them that because they're not really foods, they're wrapped up in some plastics, and when we eat them, they end up hacking our biology, they end up hacking how we feel, and that ends up impacting every area of our life, right? You already know that you should be going to the gym more, you know that you should be reading more, you know that you should be launching your business, you know what to be doing. The information is already there. In the age of information, ignorance is a choice. We can find out anything about any topic. But the question is, why can we know what to do but still not do what we know? It's because we don't feel like it. It's because our physiology has become hacked. And when we eat these foods, they end up affecting our hormones. And our hormones dictate how we feel. And what we feel ends up determining what we do more than anything else. Yes, we can flip that on its head. We can take charge of what we do to change how we feel. But for the most part, if you don't feel like doing something, you won't do it. Right? If you don't feel like going to the gym, even though you know you should, you won't do it. So how do you change this around? By having an awareness of what you feed your body temple, right? Now, there's so many different diets out there. There's so many people arguing about what's the best food, what's the worst food, whatever, right? Like, you can look at all of that stuff, but the four things that every single one of these different diet cults agree on is, first and foremost, refined sugar is not doing your body any good, right? Your taste buds taste amazing. It's something that your evolution has been designed to favor because sugar helps you give you that burst of energy. And in the environment of scarcity of food that our ancestors evolved in, which is the same biology that we have right now, it was very beneficial to go and binge on some fruit, for example. But the refined sugar that we have today, which is without the fiber as well, ends up doing a lot of damage to our body. So reduce / eliminate any refined sugar from your diet, right? Second thing is refined grains. Same thing, they act like sugar on the body. They hack your insulin, they hack your fat storage, they hack everything. And even though it tastes good in the moment, it destroys your well-being in the long term. The third thing is refined vegetable oils, okay? Now again, these are something which cause tremendous amounts of inflammation in our body. And the more inflammation we have in our body, the less likely we are to actually do the things that we know we need to do. And more than that, it actually sets the stage for a lot of the chronic conditions that we see in our society today, like cancer, diabetes, heart disease, and Alzheimer's are all rooted back in inflammation. So it's important to have an awareness of what you feed your body. I don't care what you feed your body, as long as it's not these four things, then you will be better off than 99% of people. Now, the second thing that is hacking your brain is that of social validation, which comes through social media, right? Scrolling endlessly and reactively consuming content to get that next fix, right? This is something that I've noticed in myself as well. Reactively consuming is not doing anyone any good other than the social media companies that are getting money from your attention, right? We are living in the attention hacking economy. And when your attention is not your own is when your control to change your life is not your own. You are living off of an exterior agenda, right? And the two things that are being leveraged over there is, first and foremost, random rewards, which means that it's like a slot machine. When we don't know whether we're going to get the like, the comment, the share, whatever it is, when we don't know, then we're just likely to check it again and again and again, right? They did an experiment with some rats. They're like, when this rat pushes the lever, he'll get the food. He pushes the lever, he gets the food. He pushes the lever, he gets the food. The rat stops pushing the lever eventually when he gets full. Now they bring in new rats. He's like, they push the lever, sometimes he gets the food, sometimes he doesn't. Randomly, he gets it, right? When he randomly gets it, he eats so much that he ends up getting diabetes. He ends up damaging his own well-being, right? That is what these social media companies are well aware of, and something that you must be aware of as well, so that you can manage your attention, right? We are all been hacked, right? It's like you can't unpickle a pickle. What does that mean? That means that when you put a cucumber inside vinegar and some other stuff to convert it into a pickle, you can't turn that pickle back into a cucumber. In the same way, our brains have become pickled with all these shiny objects on social media, on all these apps, right? So we can't manage our attention. It's like one screen, one of us, and thousands of the world's engineers that are creating algorithms to hack our attention, so we can't win that fight. What we can do is manage the way that we use these devices rather than have these devices use us, meaning that we can go on flight mode, meaning that we can put our phone in a different room when we are working, meaning that we can choose the time that we engage in these apps rather than just be on them 24/7 and allow the notifications to distract us, right? So very important to have an awareness on that. I'll leave a video as well in which I share how I actually manage my phone, right? How I actually manage my time and my attention with my phone. Now, the third thing is, no surprise, pornography. Okay, when we watch pixels on a screen and bust our nuts to that, not only does that drain us of our life force energy, not only does that drain us of our vitality, but it reduces the gray matter in our brain, which is the seat of our willpower, which is your ability to create yourself anew, which is your ability to change yourself in the vision of your ideals. When you don't have gray matter, which is scientifically proven to be reduced through the consumption of pornography, then you're damaging every other area of your life, right? Willpower is the queen of all virtues, which allows us to get the things done that we know we're supposed to do. But when you don't have willpower is when you don't have the will to create yourself anew, okay? So stop letting your brain get hijacked. Manage your attention so that you can manage your life, so that you can create yourself in the vision of your ideals, rather than get caught up in this agenda, in this attention hacking economy, in this agenda that is centered on making us weak so that we become dependent, so that they have the power. But you have the power only when you choose to practice it. So if you choose to practice it in these three areas is when you will begin to see some remarkable progress in your life. So I hope you found this valuable. Leave a comment below letting me know that one thing that you're going to do after watching this video, so that it is not just another information consumption, but something that you actually implement. So leave a comment below letting me know your number one implementation step after watching this video. And subscribe if you have not already. Click the like button. It really helps the channel grow. And with all that being said, I'm going to leave you in the peace and power of the one infinite creator. And I will catch you in the next one. Much love to you. Take care.